On Thursday, sir. The time is very short.
My father Capulet would have it so, and I am nothing slow to slack his haste.
You say you do not know the lady's mind? Uneven is the course, I like it not.
Immoderately she weeps for Tybalt's death, and therefore have I little talked of love, for Venus smiles not in a house of tears. Now, sir, her father counts it dangerous that she do give her sorrow so much sway, and in his wisdom hastes our marriage, to stop the inundation of her tears, which, too much minded by herself alone, may be put from her by society. Now do you know the reason of this haste?
I would I knew not why it should be slowed. Look, sir, here comes the lady toward my cell.
Happily well met, my lady and my wife.
That may be, sir, when I may be a wife.
That may be, must be love on Thursday next.
What must be, shall be.
That's a certain text.
Come you to make confession to this father?
To answer that, I should confess to you.
Do not deny to him that you love me.
I will confess to you that I love him.
So will ye, I am sure, that you love me.
If I do so, it will be of more price being spoke behind your back than to your face.
Poor soul. Thy face is much abused with tears.
Tears have got small victory by that, for it was bad enough before their spite.
Thou wrongst it more than tears by that report.
That is no slander, sir, which is a truth, and what I spake it to my face.
Thy face is mine, and thou hast slandered it.
It may be so, for it is not mine own. Are you at leisure, Holy Father, now, or shall I come to you at evening mass?
My leisure serves me, pensive daughter, now. My lord, we must entreat the time alone.
God shield I should disturb devotion. Juliet, on Thursday early will I rouse ye. Till then adieu, and keep this holy kiss.
Oh, shut the door, and when thou hast done so, come weep with me, past hope, past cure, past.
Oh, Juliet, I already know thy grief. It strains me past the compass of my wits. I hear thou must, and nothing may prorogue it, on Thursday next be married to this county.
Tell me not, friar, that thou hearest of this, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it. If in thy wisdom thou canst give no help, do thou but call my resolution wise, and with this knife I'll help it presently. God joined my heart, and Romeo's thou our hands. And ere this hand by thee to Romeo sealed shall be the label to another deed, or my true heart with treacherous revolt turn to another, this shall slay them both. Therefore, out of thy long experience, time, give me some present counsel. Or behold, twixt my extremes and me this bloody knife shall play the umpire, arbitrating that which the commission of thy years and art could to no issue of true honor bring. Be not so long to speak. I long to die if what thou speak not of remedy.
Old daughter, I do spy a kind of hope which craves as desperate an execution as that is desperate which we would prevent. If, rather than to marry County Paris, thou hast the strength of will to slay thyself, then it is likely thou wilt undertake a thing like death, to chide away this shame that copes with death himself to escape from it. And if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy.
Oh, bid me leap rather than marry Paris from off the battlements of any tower, or walk in thievish ways, or bid me lurk where serpents are, chain me with roaring bears, or hide me nightly in a charnel house, or covered quite with dead men's rattling bones, with reeky shanks and yellow chapless skulls. Or bid me go into a new-made grave and hide me with a dead man in his shroud. Things that to hear them told have made me tremble, and I will do it without fear or doubt to live an unstained wife to my sweet love.
Hold then. Go home. Be merry. Give consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Tomorrow night, look that thou lie alone. Let not the nurse lie with thee in thy chamber. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and this distilled liquor drink thou off, when presently through all thy veins shall run a cool and drowsy humour, for no pulse shall keep his native progress but surcease, no warmth, no breath shall testify thou livest, the roses in thy lips and cheeks shall fade to many ashes, thy eyes' windows fall like death when he shuts up the day of life. Each part deprived of subtle government shall stiff and stark and cold appear like death. And in this borrowed likeness of shrunk death, thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. Now, when the bridegroom in the morning comes to rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. Then, as the manner of our country is, in thy best robes, uncovered on the bier, thou shalt be borne to that same ancient vault where all the kindred of the Capulets lie. In the meantime, against thou shalt awake, shall Romeo by my letters know our drift, and hither shall he come, and he and I will watch thy waking. And that very night shall Romeo bear thee hence to Mantua, and this shall free thee from this present shame, if no inconstant toy nor womanish fear abate thy valour in the acting it.
Give me, oh, tell not me of fear.
Hold, get you gone. Be strong and prosperous in this resolve. I'll send a friar with speed to Mantua with my letters to thy lord.
Love, give me strength, and strength shall help afford. Farewell, dear father.
So many guest inviters here are writ. Sirrah! Go hire me 20 cunning cooks.
You shall have none ill, sir, for I'll try if they can lick their fingers.
How canst thou try them so?
Marry, sir, it is an ill cook that cannot lick his own fingers. Therefore he that cannot lick his fingers goes not with me.
Ah, go, be gone. We shall be much unfurnished for this time. What, is my daughter gone to Friar Lawrence?
Aye, forsooth.
Well, he may chance to do some good on her. Peevish, self-willed harlotry it is.
See where she comes from shrift with merry look.
Now, my headstrong. Where have you been garing, eh?
Where I have lent me to repent the sin of disobedient opposition to you and your behests. And I'm enjoined by holy Lawrence to fall prostrate here to beg your pardon. Pardon, I beseech you. Henceforward, I am ever ruled by you.
Send for the county. Go tell him of this. I'll have this knot knit up tomorrow morning.
I met the youthful lord at Lawrence Cell, and gave him what becomed love I might, not stepping o'er the bounds of modesty.
Why, I'm glad on. This is well. Stand up. This is as should be. Let me see the county. I marry. Go, I say, and fetch him hither. Now, afore God, this reverend, holy friar, all our whole city is much bound to him.
Nurse, will you go with me into my closet to help me sort such needful ornaments as you think fit to furnish me tomorrow?
No, not till Thursday, there is time enough.
Go, nurse, go with her. We'll to church tomorrow.
We shall be short in our provision, 'tis now near night.
Tash, I will stir about it. All things shall be well, I warrant thee. Wife, go thou to Juliet, help to deck her up. I'll not to bed tonight. Ah, let me alone. I'll play the hussy for this once. What ho! They are all forth. Well, I will walk myself to County Paris to prepare him up against tomorrow. Oh, my heart is wondrous light since this same wayward girl is so reclaimed.